Come on. Come on! Jump!
Woman! Thank you. better keep your distance if you know what's good for you.
Easy.
Choice. Hope to see you again.
How nice to see you again, Mr. Dickens. Is it time for another of the Ghost Club stories?
As a matter of fact, yes. Follow me. Number 50, Berkeley Square. Four stories high and branded, Beware All Those Who Enter. There have been many strange tales of this dreadful domicile. The earliest report of a haunting was said to be the specter of a small girl who was murdered by a servant. She could be seen at the attic windows, weeping and wringing her little hands in an agony of despair. Another legend claims the attic is haunted by the spirit of a young woman with a screaming ghost.
That's it. Easy now.
His nephew Edward was betrothed to one of Mr. Jasper's pupils, the fair and delicate Rose. However, Edward disappeared under mysterious circumstances, followed by Jasper himself. Perhaps grief sent him back to the soothing arms of his narcotic mistress.
There you are.
Shall we? Though this house is vacant, some say it comes alive at night with screams of terror, ringing bells, and slamming shutters. This phenomenon is easily produced by pneumatic tubes and valves. There are claims that a young man was caged in the attic, his only connection to the rest of the world, a tiny hole in the door. A young man who was reduced to madness by this extreme isolation. The legends all seem to focus on one room in particular. Sudden draft. Nothing more. My word. Perhaps I shall wait here while you investigate the source of that laughter, which is not at all unsettling.
Tell me, why were you at that house?
What's it to you?
Out with it.
Right, right! We were there for the treasure. We found a key to the secret passage.
What secret passage?
Yeah, number 50's got a secret passage. Here, take it. Just leave me be.
What is pertinent What are you doing in here?
You it?
You've got some bloody...
I've found a lock, but I haven't located the key.
It's here.
Ha! So this is how it works.
Impressive.
No one whose love for Rosa came near to equaling mine. It should have been enough to keep my beloved Ned away. My poor Ned. Forgive.
Alas, the myth has been discredited. There was no ghost in Berkeley Square, just a wretched soul driven to murder and madness by guilt and intoxication. I think this is the makings of a rather fine novel. I wonder if I've got one left in me.